press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss a video from News Laundry.
There's news, there's sense, and there's nuisance. This show is all about that last bit. As we record this show, the number of people infected by the COVID-19 in India stands at around 150. And 3 people have died so far. Officially, we're still at the second stage of this pandemic. The third stage would be as big an existential threat to us as human stupidity is. Sample this. Nearly 50 people were infected with COVID-19 at a church in South Korea after a church official sprayed salt water into members' mouth because they thought it would kill the virus. Elon Musk, through an email, told employees of SpaceX that they were far more likely to die from a car crash than COVID-19. For someone who's known for his shiny bright new ideas, I must say this was not your brightest moment. In all of this global stupidity, how could these Mahasabha guys stay behind? This apparently inspired a guy in West Bengal to set up a stall and sell cow dung and cow urine as a cure for coronavirus. Yeah, someone called Morbid Ali actually started selling cow urine at rupees 500 a litre and cow dung at rupees 500 a kilo and said, I quote, after I saw the Gomutra party on television, I realized I can make more profit by selling cow urine and dung. Now, I can utilize every part of cows in my business. The West Bengal police has now put Morbid Ali in jail. That's not all. A BJP activist has also been arrested for hosting a cow urine drinking event after one of the guys at this event fell ill. Wrong state, you guys. You should have just done this cow urine event in UP or MP, where they would have declared you a true Shuddh Desi Ghee Indian, and you could have even shifted careers from being a doodwala to an MP or an MLA. Bengal mein jo lawbreakers hain, wo UP mein lawmakers ban jate hain. Anyway, back to TV news. For quite some time now, our nationalist news anchors have figured a formula. No matter what's happening in the world, whatever the fuck is happening in the world, stick to 4 keywords. Keyword number 1.
Pakistan.
Keyword number 2.
Tukde tukde gang.
JNU.
Tukde tukde gang.
JNU.
Keyword number 3.
The opposition.
And finally, the latest edition. Keyword number 4.
Shaheen Bagh.
It goes a bit like this. Terror attack in Pulwama, blame JNU. Economy going down, blame the opposition. Just generally anything going wrong in India, blame Pakistan. BJP gets defeated in Delhi, blame Shaheen Bagh. But I have to say this. I thought that with the COVID-19, Pakistan, Tukde Tukde Gang, Shaheen Bagh, in sab ka up time khatam ho gaya. I was so wrong. Kyunki kuch aadatein kabhi nahi chhootti. Hamare amazing news anchors ne Shaheen Bagh ko corona ke beech mein bhi thoos diya.
Maine pehle bhi kaha tha, aaj fir keh raha hu ki Shaheen Bagh khali hona chahiye immediately. Nahi to Shaheen Bagh corona se bhi bada musibat ban jayega. Delhi ka Shaheen Bagh, Bengaluru ka Bilal Bagh, Maharashtra mein Mumbai Bagh, Chennai ka Washerman Pet. यहाँ पर मौजूद लोग प्रदर्शनकारी नहीं, देश को बीमार करने की साजिश करने वाले लोग हैं। शाहीन बाग देश को बीमार करने की अपनी जिद पर अड़ा हुआ है। शाहीन बाग में विरोध के नाम पर कोरोना फैलाने की छूट क्यों दी जा रही है कि क्या शाहीन बाग कोरोना से भी बड़ा वायरस बन चुका है?
अर्नब एंड हिज लॉस्ट कजिन फ्रॉम द कुम ऑन टाइम्स नाउ हेल्ड 2 स्ट्रेट प्राइम टाइम डिबेट्स ऑन शाहीन बाग।
शाहीन बाग प्रोटेस्टर्स वोंट बज।
द शाहीन बाग लॉबी is not just risking the lives of fellow protesters, but lakhs of Indians. Will they let their prejudices, paranoias, and narrow political motives jeopardize our collective health?
Enough. Clear Shaheen Bagh.
Does that remind you of something? There's more.
Republic is the first channel to have taken care of these Shaheen Bagh squatters. Let me tell you, all those who are sitting in Shaheen Bagh, that Republic cares for you.
Arnab cares for Shaheen Bagh protesters. For some reason, I'm not sure if Shaheen Bagh protesters would buy that Arnab cares about them, considering everything he said about them.
Shaheen Bagh, which is a useful epicenter of an anti-Hindu, anti-India, money-guzzling, opportunistic and entirely political movement.
Arnab wasn't the only one losing his shit. There was, like I said, his cousins from the Kumbh, Gaurav Sawant, Rohit Sadana, vagera vagera.
देखिए रोहित जी, मुझे लगता है कुछ लोगों को केवल हैंड सैनिटाइजर देने से काम नहीं चलने वाला है। कुछ लोगों के दिमाग के ऊपर भी अगर हम टनों सैनिटाइजेशन डालेंगे तब भी इनका दिमाग ठीक नहीं होने वाला है।
सब कुछ सब जगह तालाबंदी हो रही है लेकिन धरना चलता रहेगा, क्यों अड़े हैं आप लोग इस पर? लोगों की जान ज्यादा जरूरी है या जिद?
आर दीज प्रोटेस्टर्स अ थ्रेट नॉट जस्ट टू देमसेल्व्स बट ऑल्सो टू अदर्स?
इवन पब्लिक हेल्थ, health of the aam aadmi is of no importance to Shaheen Bagh and the protesters.
After 92 days of the blockade, anti-Modi chants and goading by the pogrom lobby, Shaheen Bagh now still continues to put protest over public health.
Is protest above public health?
Kya aap unko janwar samajhte hain? Kya wo insaan nahi hai?
Dudh muh hai, bacche baithe hain.
Dekhiye suniye, ye protest sabse bada virus.
महिलाएं बैठी है चिपक चिपक के।
पक नहीं जाते आप लोग एक ही राग अलापते अलापते। इट्स अ बिट लाइक आ सास भी कभी बहू थी एंड कहानी घर घर की टाइप सीरियल्स। इन सीरियल्स में कहानी कभी आगे मूव नहीं करती थी। डेली सोप ऑपरास को आप अगर वीकली भी देखते थे तो यू कुड फॉलो द स्टोरी एग्जैक्टली, क्योंकि फ्रॉम वन डे टू द अदर नथिंग वुड मूव। प्लॉट लाइन कहीं नहीं जाती थी। सासू माँ ने बा का अपमान किया, बा ने छोटी बहू को ऐसे देखा, फिर मीर ने बड़ी बहू को वैसे देखा। मंडे से थर्सडे इसी में निकल जाता था, नो फॉरवर्ड मूवमेंट। बट द सेट्स वर एक्सपेंसिव, हवेलीज, माउंटेन्स, कार चेजेस वगैरह वगैरह। प्राइम टाइम टीवी न्यूज हैज ऑल्सो बिकम एग्जैक्टली लाइक दी सोप ऑपेरास। सेम शाहीन बाग, सेम टुकड़े टुकड़े, सेम लॉबी, सेम प्लॉट लाइन विद जस्ट डिफरेंट सेट्स, लाइट्स एंड सूट्स। आई से टू यू गाइज व्हाट अर्नब सेड इन हिज ओन डिबेट ऑन शाहीन बाग एंड कोरोना।
Boring.
Now, I'm not saying for one minute that protesters at Shaheen Bagh should go on the way they have been. The only way that we can control the pandemic at this point is by implementing social distancing. Why? Here's the thing. Most coronavirus cases are mild, which is actually a little bit of a bad news. Because this means that you may have the virus, but the symptoms are only a mild fever or a cough and you carry on with your work. Or it could mean that you have the virus and you have no symptoms for many days. So you carry on with your life, you go to office, you go to metros, you go to clubs, and you spread this virus to other people.
These three, who are all infected but don't feel sick, go out again, on the subway, into the office, and then out after work, infecting several more people. 20% of whom will need to go to the hospital. Over a short period of time, this process multiplies the number of people going to the hospital each day. Before long, the hospital is full and a crisis begins. People with severe cases of COVID-19 can't get treatment, and some who could be saved die. Plus, people with other issues can't get treatment either, and some of them die. This surge of severe cases causes avoidable deaths. That's what happened in South Korea, Iran, and Italy, all of which went from 100 to more than 5,000 cases in less than 2 weeks.
Exactly. In South Korea, everything was seemingly under control till the 30th person was infected with the coronavirus. Then came patient number 31. Days before she was diagnosed with COVID-19, she went to crowded spots. She went to a club, got into a minor accident, so she checked into a hospital. Then she attended a church service. When doctors asked her to get tested, she didn't do that and instead went to a buffet lunch at a hotel. All this while infecting a whole lot of people. It's being said that this patient 31 could be linked to two areas in South Korea that account for about 80% of the cases in the entire country. What we do know about the novel coronavirus is that it is highly resilient. It can stay in the air for days, on plastic for 5 days, on paper for 4 days. So, all you have to do is simply touch the surface where the virus is living, put your hands on your mouth, and you'll catch it. So yeah, given everything we know about this virus, it's not safe for protesters to gather in numbers. Protesters in Shaheen Bagh should probably wind up for a while. If you're a journalist, it's fair to make this point. And if you're a journalist focused on public health, you will talk about Shaheen Bagh. you will talk about this temple gathering in Andhra Pradesh, and you would also talk about the UP government's grand plan of the Ram Navami Mela, where around 1 million people will gather. 1 million people. It's insane how the government of India's most populous state can plan to go ahead with this. If these guys were journalists, they would question the Yogi Adityanath government as much as they're questioning the Shaheen Bagh protesters. And they would not use COVID-19 as one more danda to use on Shaheen Bagh protesters. Worldwide markets are crashing. Dow, Sensex, Nifty, Nikkei, sab crash kar rahe hain out of fear of corona. Lekin hate ka stock aasman chhu raha hai. Aur hate ki dukaan chalani hai to hate ke patr manufacture karne padenge. Jaise Shaheen Bagh ke log, tukde tukde gang, Khan Market gang aur pata nahi kitne kitne gang. This formula instead of news is the perfect economic solution for low budget media environment. K serials ka itna sara budget hota tha. To ad rates bhi zyada hote the. Ye anchors wohi kaam saste mein nipta dete hain. Daily soap opera with hate, venom and revenge for quarter the price. Win for networks, win for advertisers, win for unintelligent anchors with little or no skill, all at the cost of your sanity. Which is why I say, pay to keep news free if you don't want news to become tamasha. That's all the nuisance we have for you this week. We'll be back next week. Till then, stay mad. That's the only way. Thank you so much for watching that video. If you liked that video, don't forget to like our video. Please, if you like TV Nuisance, then make sure that you like all our videos. Make sure that you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And when you forward this episode on WhatsApp to your friends and family, please ask them also to subscribe to News Laundry's YouTube channel and like our video. This is very important. Please do it. As you all know, News Laundry does not accept any advertisement from corporations or governments. We depend on our viewers and our subscribers. So the only thing that keeps us going and that allows us to do these shows is subscriber money. So please consider subscribing to News Laundry. It's only 300 rupees a month. That's cheaper than a non-veg Domino's pizza. So please, don't have a pizza for 1 month and subscribe to newslaundry.com. We also have an NL Sena project that is funded entirely by subscribers. This project is going to look into how and who funds our media. So for example, channels like Zee News, Times Now, Republic, and also News Laundry, we will put out a data on who owns these channels and how the funding is done. For that, we've set up this project. We've covered almost 3 lakh. We need to cover 50,000 rupees more. So please subscribe and please contribute to our NL Sena project. And of course, I'll repeat again, subscribe to News Laundry's YouTube channel. See you next week. Stay safe. Wash your hands. Stay at home as much as you can. Use sanitizers. And also educate and inform people around you about what to do to fight this pandemic. Stay safe. See you next week.